It was a cold morning on January 28, 1986. The world watched in horror as the Challenger Space Shuttle exploded just 73 seconds after launch, casting a dark shadow over the annals of space exploration. Amid the shock and grief, the real intrigue was yet to come. Richard Feynman, a Nobel laureate, a genius, was about to dive into the mystery. Feynman was not a newcomer to the dramatic world of scientific discovery. If you've seen the Oppenheimer biopic, you'll remember his portrayal as the quirky physicist with a knack for picking locks and cracking safes under the shroud of the Manhattan Project. In the heart of Los Alamos, Feynman was there, helping construct the first atomic bomb. But the real Feynman, the man chosen to investigate the Challenger disaster, was even more captivating than his silver screen portrayal. The Challenger disaster reverberated deeply throughout America, compelling President Reagan to demand a swift and comprehensive investigation. Entrusting the weighty task to William P. Rogers, he formed a commission of luminaries, including astronaut Neil Armstrong, astrophysicist Sally Ride, famed pilot Chuck Yeager, and Nobel-winning physicist Richard Feynman. Yet amidst their first meeting, Reagan and Rogers exchanged a hushed plea. In our quest for the truth, let us protect NASA's esteemed legacy. Within this framework, Richard Feynman stood out. His vibrant intellect and unyielding spirit marked him as distinct from the rest. But Feynman's commitment was clear. He would chase the truth, undeterred by political or bureaucratic hurdles. In this relentless quest, Feynman immersed himself in technical documents, shared coffees with engineers, and conducted secret experiments in the dark corners of labs. He navigated the labyrinth of bureaucracy to find Roger Boisjoli, an engineer who had expressed grave concerns about the O-ring's vulnerability in cold temperatures. During a public hearing, Feynman famously demonstrated this fatal flaw.
Before the event, from information that was available and understanding that was available, was it fully appreciated everywhere that this seal would become unsatisfactory at some temperature, and was there some sort of a suggestion of a temperature at which the SRB, I guess you call it, shouldn't be run?
Yes, sir. There was a suggestion of that. To answer the first question, given the configuration that we were in, that the seal would function at that temperature. That was the final judgment.
But Commission member Richard Feynman, after examining the O-ring, had a surprise.
Oh, I took the stuff that I got out of your seal, and I put it in ice water. And I discovered that when you put some pressure on it for a while and then undo it, it maintains, it doesn't stretch back, it stays the same dimension. In other words, for a few seconds at least, and more seconds than that, there's no resilience in this particular material when it's at a temperature of 32 degrees. I believe that has some significance for our problem.
This dramatic display pierced through layers of obfuscation, turning the world's attention to the truth behind the disaster. Feynman's unwavering pursuit of truth echoed his time at Los Alamos, proving his commitment to science's integrity. His words in the investigation's aftermath still resonate. For a successful technology, reality must take precedence over public relations, for nature cannot be fooled. Richard Feynman was not just a Nobel laureate or a groundbreaking physicist. He was a storyteller, a teacher, and a man with a contagious enthusiasm for unveiling the universe's mysteries. His role in the Challenger investigation amplified his extraordinary life narrative, demonstrating that curiosity, a healthy disdain for obscurity, and a hearty laugh could be our most potent tools in understanding our world. Feynman once offered his perspective on the transformative journey from being an ordinary individual to a scientist. Here was his take.
You asked me if an ordinary person, by studying hard, would get to be able to imagine these things like I imagine. Of course, I was an ordinary person who studied hard. There's no miracle people. It just happens they got interested in this thing and they learned all this stuff. They're just people. There's no talent, a special miracle ability to understand quantum mechanics or a miracle ability to imagine electromagnetic fields that comes without practice and reading and learning and study. So if you say you take an ordinary person who's willing to devote a great deal of time and study and work and thinking and mathematics and time, then he's become a scientist.
So, whenever you gaze up at the stars, remember Richard Feynman, the man who taught us that the true beauty of the universe lies not just in its expanse, but also in the joy of uncovering its secrets. He said, "The pleasure of finding things out was his greatest joy. Through his life story, that joy becomes ours."